Hello everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Okami! Last time we left off, we were at the Sasha Sanctuary. And this time, we're gonna go in the Sasha Sanctuary, and we're gonna indulge with one of the dumbest minigames in this game! As you can tell, I don't like it. Also, why is my volume up? I turn you down. I know, you're good. It's just me going crazy. It's just me going bonkers! Okay, so going on, yeah, obviously there's gonna be a lot of birds. But there are some pretty cool things to do in the Sasha Sanctuary. There are, that's worse. We got Daruma! Paint the eye. Stray bead. Yes, you will know how to, you're gonna have to know how to paint a Daruma. And, okay, got some Sasha Sanctuary cakes and stuff. Jesus Christ, thank you. And also attack it, it gives you fruit. It gives you oranges, man. You want some nice oranges! I'm sorry for everyone who grew up on an island or grew up in Jamaica. Hey, it's Mr. What's-His-Face. Hi, dude. We got some rats. Apparently rats prefer meat. Okay, that's... I would say concerning, but no, rats, or mice and rats do eat meat. You'll get nothing, sir! Good day, sir! God, dear God. I actually haven't seen Willy Wonka in a while, so my memory of Willy Wonka may be botched a bit. So, we got rooms upon rooms of pretty much, you know, residents or people staying at the Sasha Sanctuary. And we can talk to the people working here, but there's really no interest to do it. Also, more food. Take all the food. Holy crap, that's a lot of food. That's too much food! Holy Christ! Whee! Alright. So we got some ink, and also, that is basically a sitar. I do not know what this is called, actually. Even though I probably just said and I'm not paying attention. Whoops. Okay, cool. So pretty much they all have nothing to say that's important, so just on the way. Alright, that's the thing. What? Stylish! That is awesome. I love the little layer they have in this area. And I'm gonna be straight up, this is not the only area in this game you're gonna see of this, so get used to it. So let's go meet the big boss. Yay! Boss is behind the inn, you're able to relax. But, you know, that's not why we come in here. We come here to steal your stuff. We are going to steal everything that they have because... One, we kind of need it for completionist sake, and two, I don't personally care. Traveler's Charm, okay. Wooden Bear, even better. Steel Fist Sake, eh. Dragon Beads. Glass beads. Ugh, excuse me. I am. Do not drink iced tea. Steal soul sake. And that's all we need to get from here. Was there any point to coming here? Nope. Just for treasure. Also, hi. Bathed. Hi. Yep, so you pretty much said nothing important. Alright, did you hit R1 and it locks the camera? Oh yeah, practically does. What are you doing? Excuse me, please wait a moment. No, let's talk about house, sorry, Earthquake, Something's scaring the water, essentially. Okay. So we get into my favorite, or my favorite to hate area. Basically, all it is, it's a mini game, but this mini game really kind of sucks. I see where people like it, but at the same time, I see where people hate it. I'm kind of middle road with this. Hey, Mr. Bamboo. So basically, it's a dowsing rod. Okay, Mr. Bamboo. Yeah, let's help dig up the hot springs. So basically, welcome to the digging game. I hate this digging minigame sometimes, but that's mostly later in the game. But right now, it's very easy, and I'm gonna do just fine explaining this. So basically, you're allowed to use your celestial brush, but you are on a timer. This makes this game ridiculously freaking hard later, but you can boost your time by certain things. So let's bloom you, break you, get the time bonus, dig here before he comes wandering back, and power slash this because you're gonna need to drop down a bit. Power slash this, bloom this thing, dig here. And pretty much, I'm going to show you the most direct way of getting to the bottom, because, you know, I'm pretty sure no one wants to waste their time playing this game. This game kind of sucks. So, soft dirt only takes one, you know, little ding. Stronger dirt takes two, and basically it's headbutts or power slashes, or not power slashes, headbutts or cherry bombs, even though cherry bombs blow everything up in one go. Also, if he's going the wrong way, you can power slash him, but this area is small enough, it's not going to matter too much. So let's bloom this, and we'll get some extra time for a bit. So we basically got 2 minutes and 50 seconds to screw around with. So we're going to wait for Mr. Bamboo to fall, and here's the trick. Bloom the characters you're helping, because it makes them move faster and dig a spot where they're going crazy at. Basically, for Mr. Bamboo, disco pose. That's the minigame. It gets ridiculous later, trust me. Also, I'm gonna have a bit of my water because it's water area. Sorry, I don't drink little tiny pieces of water, sorry. I'm everywhere, never lies. Yep, quest is well done. It's us. You better not forget it. That was hard work. And Omni's not exactly thrilled to take the bath. Something is happening again, and we know what the drill. Hopefully by now, this is like, what, the 7th? So basically, you know, get the drill. It's a 3-star area. I did it! Important little snake guy. So we got Nirogami. And I really have nothing to say about this one, so I'm gonna be quiet. For the rest of them too, probably. So basically, like, the Blossom thing, we, not Power Slash, I didn't draw it. You gotta draw a line to what you wanna click and where you wanna, or the source of water and then the exit source of water. This makes it a very interesting power to do, and it's actually pretty interesting how they go about this. So, little water things like that, draw straight up or slightly up because I moved up, and that makes a little water spout. This, once again, is a fantastic power. Also, there's upgrades later in the game, but we're not there yet, so I'm gonna shut up about that. And trust me, this is a lovely power. I love using Water Spout in any type of game, even if it's crappy like Pokemon. You know why? Because it's really cool, and also there was nothing out there. Hopefully, if there was, I'm gonna regret it later, because I have to go back. So, Bamboo, if you've seen any Japanese, is basically Water Bird. So you put some water in the bamboo, it goes down and up, and then it triggers a switch. Now, if people remember, there was something we needed to check out here, which was probably relevant to the Canine Warriors. So you can probably safely assume what we're going to be doing and how we're going to be doing it. This is not a fun one. I remember this one, and I don't remember liking it. But in return, we get birds! Birds! Screw you, I wanted birds! We don't even have sea bags. Okay, never mind. I'll come back with sea bags a bit later because we can't do a whole lot now. Also, hello, Mr. Bird. Tweet, tweet. Okay. Crybaby Town! Oh, that's kind of appropriate for him. You lost your dog, really? And of course, there's a Canine Warrior relevant thing. So of course we're gonna be here and we're gonna do a Canine War here. Side quest, you know, it's the main quest, so main side quest. This is probably one of the easiest ones if I remember correctly. Also, it could be the most frustrating depending on your style. So we got tigers! Feed the tigers! Roar! And with that, we get introduced to the Flashing Bamboo. This is ridiculous. We gotta cut down the right one at the right time. So basically, wait for half a second. Make sure you have all the bamboo in your clear sight. And then when it blows, slash it. What? That was dead on, gang. Tweak! Takes back! I guess we have to fight to prove the worth. Now, this is Canine Warrior Gi. I do not know, once again, don't ask me. So, we gonna pick a fight? Of course we are! And of course we're not going to hold back because this is no joke of a fight too. This is probably one of the hardest fights in the game. Because I did not like the Canine Warrior, or at least at this point of the game. And yes, that's a little hint to war something later. Or something relevant to Canine Warriors. Or something like Canine Warriors. So don't get- I didn't hit the button game, I told you to jump. Okay, now we're going to jump because I'm going to put it up. And you are going to just jump all over the damn place. Can you stop jumping? Yeah, open the floor. Open the door. Get on the floor. Everybody wants a dinosaur. That's not how you do the dinosaur. You know what? I'll be a jerk. Oh, that was lucky! No, stop trying to poop on us. And yes, that's basically a poop attack. I do not like stat. Hey, hey dog, go away. I'm a freaking range fighter, not a close up person. Go. Tell you my victory. Yeah, we're gonna leave him alone because he kinda lost to us. But he cannot return, dangerous, and overrun Sasha Sanctuary without me. So basically he's indebted to the Sasha Sanctuary because he wants to protect them. So considering everything that's transpired, I think he can click on to what they all mean. Are we gonna care though? No, because we got the call, the Orb of Duty. I was at Call of Duty, but no, we're not talking about a crappy video game. It's crappy. Ugh. I don't know what to say. I don't like Call of Duty. I think after my reaction, I think you guys would know that I don't like Call of Duty. Never mind. So let's just slash. Slash the lanterns. Okay, maybe you can't slash them. Nope, they're infeasible. Also, don't get mad at your dog. Okay, tigers, bite them. And move, because they will be out for blood on their first attack. Bottom line, don't bite a tiger. And don't bite your taiga. That's weird. I kid you not, I expected my sister to come in my room and go like, no! So yeah, those birds, we're gonna come back to feed them. Probably off camera, but you know what? It doesn't really matter, does it? Because we already got their type. Also, hi Mr. Bamboo! I get it. Not really looking forward to taking a bath, Mr. Bamboo. Night of a full moon, huh? Okay. Oh, the legend we were told at the beginning of the game. Okay, thank you. 100 years, huh? That's pretty cool. Woo! Thank you for the mermaid coin. Except we are never gonna use that because I don't normally find the need to. Like, but why? Because pretty much everything is plot relevant, and also I like traveling through the game once in a while. And you know, I'm not exactly a warper. Especially like Legend of Zelda stuff too. I like never warp in Legend of Zelda stuff. That's an ugly bird. And people are like, what, you a bird racist? No, I'm clearly saying that they drew her to look ugly. Do you sell stuff? No, you don't. Fuck off. Also, I do not like the camera. Is that a fixed camera or is that just how the camera is right now? Either or, that kind of sucks. But now with our water technique, we could go help Kuji with her little, you know, her little basket thing she was trying to do. So let's hurry our butts up and, you know, just swiftly run to the Agata Falls. We're right there, so I don't really think I have to talk, well, I don't have to edit that much. I'll just keep talking to you guys. Because, you know, it gives you a chance to hear the Agata music. Not Agata, the talk of past music. So, you know, well, I guess now would be a good time if any, because I don't upload these like every day. I try to keep, when I do upload them, I usually do two at a time. So, how do you guys feel about Okami so far? I'm probably going to be a little advanced in recording compared to what you guys are going to see, but I hope you guys really like it. Like, I feel like this game is very beautiful, and like, it's been praised for a while, and like, people do go back to the game and say, like, oh yes, it's been praised. I was wondering, like, do you guys have the same feeling? Because I know a lot of my fans or friends, that mostly people who watch me are my friends. Yeah, I want to know if you guys find this very cool or interesting. Like, I want to tell you guys, like, it's a very good game. Like, if you can, buy a copy of it. It's pretty much out for everything. It's out for the PS2, well, it's originally on the PS2. It's out for the Wii. It's out for the PS3. So, like, fairly cheap system. You can just buy that off on... So now back with Kuji, how do you pronounce your name, I'm gonna try to swap botch the pronunciation. So now we're gonna get the water into her little basket, because, you know, she's a little, she's not exactly the smartest bunch today. So three times, and that fills up her entire ballast. So she's ready to make the eight purification sake. So it makes it really cool, and also I was kind of scared that I'd give stuff away. I think I did. I'm sorry, folks. Oh, come on, I just put my drink down. What's that? It's a red imp, but she won't know it. Do you want some of the spring water? I don't think I want the spring water. I don't think it cares. Wow, that's what the hell just happened? See, even she doesn't know. Susano! Hi, Susano! How have you been? Just taking a walk. What if I run into? Hi, Susano! You gonna give them your special technique? Will it really be the last? Susano, you better get ready to slash some things. Susano, please don't break. You're cool. You can take them on. We believe in you. You have the Susano style exploding slash or whatever. Yes, it does, Ami. I call you Ami. You're Isu. I swing my sword in the name of love! Susano style, sword of passion, here I go, really? You, slash, leave my sushi alone. Please, Susano, please, don't watch out until it's done. You did it, Pops! That was amazing! Oh man, Susano, you're the best! Really, Susano? Okay, apparently we might have traumatized Susano. Shut up, Isu! He kind of buggered off. Yeah, that did sound like him. That kid is in trouble, so let's go help him. help one person to go help another. Canine tracker. So that clearly means something. Are you, sure? You're okay? I think we can help you. You see, I think we can help her. Here, have some water. Not power slash, have some water. There, that should help you. You're not gonna die from exhaustion. Okay, so basically, back to the point where we got the key from. So, let's hop. Hop again. Worship it! And make it dry. Oh, what the? Well, your dog's alive, kid. So, next time on Okami, we're gonna jump right back to this and start the